Astronomers claim we are living in a nebula. Nebulae are like the supermodels of the universe. They are stunningly beautiful and everyone wants to capture a picture of them. But surprisingly, they're not as well known as you might think. Allow me to explain. The term nebula has always been a bit confusing because it's been used to describe different things. But thanks to some amazing discoveries, scientists have been able to somehow classify them. What we found is that some are so huge they stretch out for hundreds of light years. Now here's the really cool part. Most nebulae are where stars are born. Take the Orion Nebula, for example. It's one of the most famous ones out there, and it's actually one of the most photographed things in the night sky. This beautiful nebula has given us a peek into how stars and even whole planetary systems are formed. You see, these objects are made up of clouds of gas and dust. When they collapse under their own gravity, they start to form new stars. It's like watching a cosmic nursery in action. These stunning objects might not be as famous as they deserve to be, but they hold the key to understanding the birth of our universe. Would you believe me if I told you you are living in one of them? Keep watching the video to get to know more about it. What a nebula is not. Imagine being an early astronomer gazing up at the night sky and discovering something unusual. There amidst the twinkling stars, you spot a hazy object that resembles a cloud. Curiosity grips you, and you decide to give it a name, Nebula. Years later, much to your surprise, another astronomer reveals what you had dubbed a nebula is actually so much more than just a cloud. It is a galaxy or star cluster, a vast system containing billions of stars. The term nebula becomes a reminder of the early days of astronomy, when anything cloud-like was labeled as such. In the present day, our understanding has expanded. We now know that galaxies are colossal assemblages of gas, dust, and billions of stars, all bound together by the force of gravity. Each galaxy is like a bustling metropolis, hosting countless solar systems and their accompanying planets. On the other hand, star clusters are smaller gatherings, comprising 10 or more stars that originated from the same interstellar cloud. These clusters can be found throughout the universe, varying in size and composition. Some of the most impressive ones, known as globular clusters, orbit galaxies and hold hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of stars. These clusters are especially remarkable because they contain some of the oldest stars ever observed. Their age gives us insight into the history of our universe, revealing secrets from a time long past. As you can understand, a nebula is not a galaxy nor a cluster. So what is it exactly? What a nebula is. A nebula is a massive cloud formed by dust and gases, predominantly hydrogen and helium, that exists in the vastness of space. It can originate from the remnants of a dying star, such as a supernova explosion. As we've already said, nebulae are considered to be star nurseries. If you think about it, these mesmerizing formations actually symbolize the ceaseless cycle of birth and death occurring within the cosmos. As stars reach the end of their lives, they explode in a cataclysmic supernovae, scattering their remnants into the surrounding space. These remnants then lay the foundation for future star formation, perpetuating the cosmic dance of creation and destruction. The composition of a nebula comprises dust and gases that are dispersed throughout, but the force of gravity can initiate the consolidation of dust and gas clumps. Subsequently, as these clumps increase in size, their gravitational pull intensifies. Nebulae occupy the interstellar space between stars. A captivating image captured by NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope showcases it as an eerie eyeball-like figure. Situated in the constellation Aquarius, this nebula resides at a staggering distance of 700 light-years away from our planet. Among the known nebulae, it stands as the closest to Earth. Its existence provided researchers with invaluable insights into the nature of stellar evolution and the processes involved in the formation of new stars. By studying nebulae like the helix, scientists can unravel the mysteries of the cosmos and deepen their understanding of the universe we reside in. Now, astrophysicists claim the solar system is basically immersed in one of those nebulae, the local interstellar cloud. The local interstellar cloud. The local interstellar cloud belongs to the so-called emission-type nebulae, made of ionized gases that emit light of various wavelengths. With an average temperature that can reach 7,000 degrees Kelvin, this gas is hotter than the sun's surface temperature. The hottest particles can reach up to 1,000,000 Kelvin degrees. However, this nebula is really sparse. Its density is really low at only 0.3 particles per cubic centimeter. In comparison, Earth's atmosphere at the edge of space, i.e. 100 kilometers above sea level, has around 1.2 times 10 to 13 molecules per cubic centimeter, dropping to around 50 million at 400 kilometers of altitude. This in turn means that the gas in the nebula has a very low heat capacity. If you were in the middle of it, it would barely heat you up at all. That's why even if we are embedded in it, we don't actually burn. Phew. But how do we know we're in it? The local interstellar cloud is an interesting and unique phenomenon in space. It is a type of nebula made up of ionized gases that emit light in different colors. These gases are incredibly hot, even hotter than the surface of the sun. In fact, the temperature can reach up to 1,000,000 degrees Kelvin. Despite its extreme heat, the local interstellar cloud is actually quite sparse. Its density is very low, with only 0.3 particles per cubic centimeter. To put that into perspective, the Earth's atmosphere at the edge of space has around 1.2 times 10 to 13 molecules per cubic centimeter. So even though we are surrounded by this nebula, it doesn't have enough particles to heat us up significantly. Phew, we don't have to worry about getting burned. By studying this particular nebula, scientists can gain insights into the formation and evolution of stars and galaxies. It also provides valuable information about the conditions in space and the impact they may have on our planet and life on Earth. But how do scientists know that we are in the local interstellar cloud? Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. How do we know? Well, the answer to this question is quite easy. They have used various scientific instruments and observations to gather this information. By studying the very faint light emitted by the gases in the nebula, scientists have been able to determine its composition and characteristics. They also measured the density of the particles in the cloud and compared it to other regions in space. Based on these measurements, they have concluded that we are indeed located within the local interstellar cloud. There's really nothing much more than this. It's just a matter of taking a lot of data, analyzing it, and eventually coming up with some conclusions. It is hard and long work, but it pays off in the end. Perhaps what's more interesting than proving its existence is to know what structure it has. Indeed, studying this nebula's property is more important for us because it helps us learn more about the universe and how it works. The local interstellar cloud structure. The local interstellar cloud, known as the LIC, may be faint, but it possesses a distinguishable structure like any other nebula. Despite its boundary-like appearance, scientists have discovered that it exhibits a defined structure. To put its vastness into perspective, if you were to emit light from one end of the LIC, it would take 30 years for someone on the opposite end to observe the light. This incredible time delay is due to the fact that the LIC spans a staggering distance of 30 light years. What adds to its intrigue is the realization that this cloud is not stationary, but exists independently of our movement. In essence, we are akin to an airplane traversing through the clouds, with the LIC serving as our celestial surroundings. However, just as an airplane eventually exits the clouds, we too will bid farewell to the LIC approximately 20,000 years from now. Superbubble, Remnant, Supershell. Astronomers have made an intriguing discovery about the local interstellar cloud. It's not alone. In fact, it is part of a much larger group of clouds known as a local bubble. One of the clouds within the superbubble is the neighboring G cloud, which is where the solar system will enter once it bids farewell to the local interstellar cloud. Inside the local bubble, the density of atoms is significantly lower than the average density of the local interstellar cloud. It is estimated to be only 0.05 atoms per cubic centimeter. This disparity in density can be attributed to the formation of these clouds through supernovae explosions that occurred within the past 10 to 20 million years. These explosions expelled material and gas, creating clouds. However, some of the atoms that were expelled became trapped in the middle of nowhere, leading to the formation of regions with higher density. This is how we think our local interstellar cloud formed. Initially, it was believed that Geminga, a pulsar in the Gemini constellation, was the remnant of a single supernova that gave birth to the entire local bubble. However, recent studies now suggest that also multiple supernovae from the Pleiades were also responsible for its formation. Consequently, astronomers refer to the local bubble as a remnant supershell. As we venture beyond these nebulae, we enter a new realm of interstellar space. The vastness of the local bubble reveals the interconnectedness of the universe, highlighting that our solar system is just a small part of a larger cosmic ecosystem. Through continued exploration and study, astronomers hope to uncover even more secrets and gain a deeper understanding of the intricate dynamics that shape our galactic neighborhood. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. How does it feel like living in a nebula? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you guys next time on the channel.